nothing too spectacular here. These are the bump stops. This is the lower bump stop. And this is the upper one. One thing you should know, the old school bump stops had, and I've said this in other videos, but I know not everybody watches all the videos, so I'm gonna keep saying the same stuff in a lot of these videos as I work on different cars, just to give you a warning. So I apologize to those who have to hear it over and over again. But the old bump stops had like a square end here, and that would fit into the square hole here and square hole here. These new ones don't. So you just gotta try to hold it, the bottom one, hold it to keep it, to square it up. And the top one doesn't really matter because it's just round. But you just gotta make sure you hold it really good so that it doesn't spin on you and you're unable to tighten it up. So anyway, we'll do that. Now what I usually do is I'll usually take the lowers and I'll cut off part of it, probably about right in there or so. So I'll take a Zaw to this one and I'll cut it off before I actually put it on the control arm. The last one I did, I think it was the 68 Charger. I had already bolted it up, so I sawed it while I was on the car, but you know, there's a lot of stuff that gets in the way, so it's easier to cut it. I'll put it in a vise and cut it before I bolt it on. Something else I should mention, the reason you don't need to cut the top ones, let me back up. Actually, you don't have to cut any of these if you don't want to, including the bottom one. I cut the bottom one because I like my cars really low. So if you don't cut this, usually when I drop my cars, my Mopars, it's usually right about here, just about to hit the frame. So by cutting this off, that gives me a little bit of, you know, distance between the bump stop and the frame so that, you know, the suspension can move a bit as you're driving the car. So I don't know how low I'm gonna go on this car. It's my mom's car. I don't want it slammed low. You know, it's gotta be really practical, but I'm probably gonna give it a 1-inch drop all the way around. Probably don't have to cut these, but I'll cut it anyway just as a little, you know, security blanket. Give it a little bit extra space to travel. You don't have to cut these, the top ones, because when the car is low, the control arm is going to be up higher, and so it's going to be less likely to impact that, you know, unless you jump the car and it fully extends. This is for when you have full extension, so the body of the car is going away from the ground. The upper control arm is going to come down and hit this. The bottom one is for compression. So when the weight of the car comes down, the suspension is going to go up and it's going to impact this. So yeah, we got to get that lower for this car. But if you're doing a stock height on your Mopar, you know, you could totally leave this if you want to. Like I said, this is just a me thing. I'm not recommending you do it unless you like your car is really low. This is why I do it. I just cut it for the extra space. So, up to you. All right, I'm gonna come in with a Sawzall and I'm just gonna start cutting on this bad boy. There you have it. A shortened bump stop. Yeah, it's not perfect. It's not perfectly flat, but what do you expect for a Zaw? It's good enough, it'll do the job. Cool. Whew, smells like burnt rubber. All right, that looks good. I got my my shortened bump stop that I cut the tip off of here, so because I like my cars really low. So that gives me just a little more clearance before it hits the frame of the car. So these upper A-arm bushings are all, the shells are all raw. So I think I'm gonna go rattle can all that black. Oh, these are actually lower control arm bushings, pivots. But these are the upper arm bushings, which, like I said, are raw. So I'm gonna go rattle can all this black because it's just gonna turn to rust instantly. And then we're gonna press them into the upper arms. All right, we're gonna press the upper control arm bushings into the upper arms here. I already put a little bit of grease around here. This is our tool. Take this off. Pretty sure we don't need that going together. It's just gonna go in here like this. And this is what's gonna push it into the control arm. And then this is gonna create a pocket on this side for the bushing to go into. And we just put this on and tighten it all up. So, I don't know if I went too far. Basically cut the rubber up here too far, I guess. The thing is you have to press it in. You have to keep pressing it till this outer shell bottoms against that, which is what I did. Maybe I went too far, I don't know. I have another set of these. Hopefully their quality's a little better. So I'm gonna press that back out. I'm gonna try these ones. And I think I'm not gonna paint it just so it doesn't add, you know, interference and friction. So I'm gonna go ahead and press them in first and then I'll paint it. I'll have to tape it off or whatever and then paint it on the control arm. All right, last time I left this sleeve out and I let this part push against the whole bushing, but I'm gonna leave this sleeve in so that it pushes closer to the center, maybe doesn't squish out the rubber as much. I don't know, see what happens. All right, aside from this guy popping off for whatever reason, popped back in okay. Once it's in there and sandwiched into the frame of the car, it's not gonna go anywhere. But that went together way better. So either the sleeve pushing close to the center was better, or the quality of this bushing is a lot better, which I kind of think it's the quality of the bushing too. This rubber is probably weak. Anyway, we'll take this one back off and replace it with a good one. All right, that is perfect. Let me go, I'm gonna wipe this up, hit it with some spray paint, and then we'll put it in the car. All right, we're gonna put the upper control arms in. I've already got the upper bushings pressed in, as you saw earlier. I'm not gonna put the ball joint in yet because I've said it a million times, but I keep saying it. It's better to use the car as your vise to hold the control arm while you're sitting there turning the ball joint in. So we're gonna get our eccentrics here. I'm gonna get this going. I think I'm gonna need a rubber mallet too. Oh, by the way, if you are worried about which side the control arm goes on, driver's side or passenger side, if you look at this, you can see there's a pad area here stamped in the control arm. That pad area aligns to that bump stop. So that's how we know this is the driver's side. So I've always seen the eccentrics go from the inside out. So the bolt head, eccentric washer, and bolt, that's all one piece. Push it from the inside through the car. All right, so these are 3/4 inch. So I usually just kind of, for starters, position the bolts so they're facing straight up. So they're facing straight up like this. And then when you go to align the car, you're gonna twist this one way or the other, and that's gonna pull the arm out or push it in. That was the cornet talking to me. Hood spring. I try to put the eccentric washers back the way they would came in. To me, there's like a flat side and then kind of the top of the stamped side. You can tell by the edges being kind of curved. It doesn't mean you have to do it this way. In fact, I don't know, it might actually be better the other way. But that's how this side is. So we'll stick to that. That on there. I have to turn this to get the flat side to line up. All right, I'm not gonna tighten these things down a lot. I'm just gonna kind of, bring the nut close so that the eccentric washers are sitting in the pockets pretty well. Like I said, I'm not gonna tighten it. I wanna leave it loose enough that I can still, move it around. That should have pulled the arm out, which would have brought the center line of the ball joint towards the back. I was turning on it, so I don't know if it actually, I know it moved, but I don't know how far. Basically pulled the bolt over this way so the control arm moved forward, kind of at it, well, out and forward. So put it back. Hopefully that was visible. And let's move this one back. Oh. Maybe show
see the bolt head, how it's facing forward. So that pulled the control arm in,
and the center line. Is only plastic, and the center line basically forward. So that's how you adjust your alignment on the car. There's no alignment other than ride height on the lower control arm and your tie rod ends, which is your toe in and toe out, but your camber and caster is all controlled from the upper control arm. So we'll get into that once we get the car all back together. Should be good educational video. Everything we did to the other side, we are now going to do to this side. And actually, I'm going to put a little tiny bit of grease on here. I didn't do it to the other side. And I don't think it's going to cause it to slip and move or anything like that, because it's really mechanical. The eccentrics are basically pulling on these tabs on this side and this side. So it's not like the grease is gonna cause the eccentric bolt to slip and rotate. So, all right, anyways, let's go ahead and knock this guy in. And as you recall, the bump stop's gonna go here. Here's the pad for the bump stop to hit. So we know that this is the actual passenger side. All right, these have a 3/4 inch head on them. I'm gonna rotate it to basically just bring the control arm to the nominal position or central position. So it's not too far in, not too far out. This is just gonna be my starting point. Yep. Okay. It's on, no problem. Now, let me rotate this back. Get it in the pocket. All right, if you kind of saw me struggling there on this side, basically you see the ears here, the centric's got to be in between those ears. On the opposite side, on this side, the centric was just outside of the ears. Let's go up top side. Okay, so this eccentric washer was up on top of this ear. So I had to loosen it up and push the control arm, or actually rotate this so that it would pop in here better. And now I could tighten it up some more. So it's still a little bit loose. I'll tighten a little more. And like I said, we'll get it all set up so it's straight up and down, and we'll call it done. That one looks pretty good. It could come this way a little bit for our starting point. So we'll do that. And then I'm sure it's gonna move once I start tightening, but that's about right. All right.